classical computers in our daily life and everywhere. So we play music, we play games with them, and we use internet, and actually computers are making our life more easier, right? So, but there's some problems we cannot solve with classical computers. So that's why we need quantum computers. Actually, it is kind of the same reason for quantum mechanics. We cannot explain everything with classical mechanics. That's why we need quantum mechanics. Because when we talk about speed of light, classical mechanics is not working actually. So there's some capacity of quantum computers. They can do multitasking like us women. You can give 10 or 20 different tasks to quantum computers. They won't get confused, they won't get tired. They will do all job in the same time and with really good result. And also, they're really good about factorization. For example, there's an example, there's two numbers, we don't know what is P or Q. If you will, if you want to understand what is P or Q, if you will use classical computers, it will take this much time. But with quantum computers, it is only 100 seconds. So this is maybe more understandable. Let's say you are trying to find the exit with classical computer, it needs to try all paths one by one. But quantum computers, it has all probabilities and it will try always at the same time and it will give you result in a short time. This is really crazy, right? So this is just beginning actually. So classical computers, their units is bits. For all information, we need to use zeros or one. But this is not same for quantum computers. Quantum computers' units are qubits. It names quantum bits. So they are not zero or one. They are zero or one at the same time, zero and one. And they are in superposition actually. So I will try to explain how qubits are working. I have coin, and let's say heads are zero and tails are one. So when I flip the coin, in the air it was acting like qubit, right? Nobody can say it was head or tail. So I'm gonna flip the coin again, and now I wanna measure what is the result. When I wanna measure, it will collapse in one state, and then I can understand what is my result. So now it is a number, so it's one. So now I need to explain some quantum mechanics because quantum computers are working with quantum mechanics rules. There is two main rules, they're really important. One of them is superposition, which is I just told you, and second one is entanglement. Superposition, maybe you heard about Schrödinger cat. There's a closed box and there's a cat inside it with a bomb, let's say. Until you open the lid, you are not sure the cat is dead or alive, right? It's 50% it's dead, 50% it's alive. So on the right picture, you can understand maybe more easily because until you open the door, the plates are broken or not broken at the same time. Yeah, the second crazy thing is entanglement. Let's say I have two particles and I put them in a different state, which is entanglement states. After that, they will act like pairs. They will become couples. If I do one operation on the first particle, it will affect the second one at the same time. Even if they are really far away from each other, I can send the second particle to another planet or another galaxy. Again, same, if I want to do something on first particle, it will affect second one at the same time. So Einstein said that it is spooky action at a distance. They're mimicking each other, actually. And also, if I want to understand what's my state of particle, because particles has two states, up or down states, again, superposition, I will observe my first particle. If it's up, I can understand at the same time the second particle was down state. So there's another example, maybe easy to understand. Let's say I have two gloves, they're coupled, one left hand and right hand. Let's say I receive one of them, A box, the second one we send it to Little Prince, which is he travels another galaxies. So I will open my box, I will understand which gloves is with me. So actually I forgot my gloves, so this is, let's say this is left hand, and now we all know which one Little Prince has, right? It should be right hand. This is another crazy thing, because it is entanglement superpositions working with quantum computers. You might think it is just theoretical mumbo jumbo, but actually it is not, because physicists, they confirm entanglement superposition in the labs with experiment. And also Chinese researcher, they beamed one photon to satellite. How it will affect our life, in daily life, you can ask. You all know beam up Scotty. Maybe one day we can come that point, we might teleport a team to another planet. We are not there yet, and also teleportation is working only one way transfer. And I know all these things is really hard to understand, and this slide is actually for us. There's a guy, he read the quantum mechanics 1,000 times, still he didn't understand. So, and also Feynman said that if you say I understood quantum mechanics, actually you didn't understand, because it's really hard to understand. And who is Feynman? He's one of the famous physicists. He said that we need to, if you want to understand nature, we need to build quantum computers. And also quantum computers can help to solve our quantum mechanics problems. And on the left side, you can see one of the first computer we had. It was really big. One room was just one computer, actually. Nowadays, we use computers in our package. Phones are a computer. And on the right side, you can see IBM quantum computers. Right now, they're really big. They look like fridge, because they need to make it really cold, even they're colder than outer space. So the purpose is not having quantum computers in our package, but nowadays they're thinking about we can use quantum computers with AI, artificial intelligence. So most of you know, you use actually Google Assistant, and you heard about Sophia. She can talk, she can make jokes, and there's one more Sophia, Little Sophia. They create one more Sophia. The purposes of Little Sophia is helping to your kids. She can teach math or science. Google Assistant can make phone calls for you. And they're using slang language, by the way. They're not like ordinary robots. So after that, I will explain my ideas, because we are not there yet. We are not using quantum computers with artificial intelligence, actually. There is another example, difference between classical and quantum computers. Again, when we want to use Google Map, let's say I want to go to Nicosia, and I type to Google Map, show me the shortest way or the fastest one. He need to use all paths one by one. He calculate that, and then it's giving us the result. But with, again, quantum computers, it has all paths. It will give you the result at a short time. So how it will help us? We are talking about autonomous cars or self-driving. So we need database. If we will start to use quantum computers with artificial intelligence, it will really develop our life, actually, upgrade. This is another example. Let's say archaeologists dig a place and they find the artifact, but it's split everywhere. So they want to combine with each other to understand what is that artifact, and also the age of that artifact and the other properties. With classical computers, again, it needs to put pieces one by one to have whole picture, right? Again, with quantum computers and AI, we can use all paths at the same time, and we will have the result in a short time. And this is the famous black hole photo. This is the first black hole photo, and the team was working around two years about that photo, analyzes that photo, and there are not just a few people, more than 100 people was working on this photo. I believe that quantum computers and artificial intelligence will help about data analysis also. And also, I believe that one day we will find our cousins from other planets. And till now, I just give positive examples about quantum computers and artificial intelligence, but on the other hand, there's bad side also. Some scientists, even Hawking, said that human race will get killed by robots. They might right, because machines are everywhere, cameras are watching us, all computers are know our daily life or even our private lives. So, but also, I believe that we are not that much innocent. We are the biggest reason for global warming. We are biggest reason for the animal extinction. When we start to use artificial intelligence with quantum computers, we might solve our global problems. And also, yeah, technology is really going fast. It's growing really fast. But nobody can stop technology, development of technology. Even early men, they didn't have anything and they start to have some tools. And in time, they make it better and better, right? And nobody can stop technology. I said the same things again. But we can set some ethical rules. And nobody can say they will kill us. I believe nobody should say they will kill us or they will all positive. Only time will show us. Thank you.